right, so we're gonna be discussing data logging today. I am retuning my car, so this is version 2 of my custom tune. The reason why I'm doing this is because on the dyno testing video, I'll link that right up here, I did some data logging and I noticed that my timing is all over the place. I had some knock events and my high pressure fuel pump is completely maxed out. So I went ahead and sent these logs to Kerry Jordan, had him take a look at them, and he said, yeah, let's take it down a notch. So not that fun because we're going from 19.2 pounds boost, and right now I'm sitting at 18.2, so we dropped a PSI. This tune isn't done yet, but I figured I'll kind of take you through my process and why I'm retuning, and maybe you need to retune your car as well, because I'd rather have it be reliable, fun, fast, daily, and not have to worry about any issues. All right, so let's head home and take a look at some data logs. I'll show you what I look for, and I'll show you kind of where my high pressure fuel pump is getting maxed out in the mid-range. Maybe you can throw some 2 cents in the comments, how much boost you're running, what octane you're running. Being here in California, we are very octane limited. 91 gas is awful. So I'm actually running an E30 tune, but I'm putting 5% more gas in to clean up my timing. So I'm technically running an E35 tune, and I'll show you how that cleaned up my timing. All right, so let's go over some data logs. This first data log is from my custom tune version 1 from the dyno testing video. So the car did great on the dyno. Again, 425 horsepower, 515 foot-pounds of torque. That's all cool and everything, but I want my car to be happy and reliable, and this is my daily, and I don't wanna worry about any engine failure in the future. So first thing I look for in a data log is to see if there's any knock detected. That's that pink line right here. Unfortunately, we have a knock detected right here. When it comes to knock, if you do a series of 3 pulls, if you see knock, more than one occurrence of knock on each of those 3 pulls, then you're either got a bad batch of gas, you're octane limited, or this tune is too aggressive for your car. If you do 3 pulls and you have 1 knock detected and the other 2 show 0 knock detected and timing looks good, then you don't have to worry about it. Knock is going to happen, and that's coming from Kerry Jordan himself. So that gave me a little bit of peace of mind because I didn't want to see knock at all. Obviously you don't want to see that, but that's the first thing I look for when I open up a data log. Second thing I do is I head to the beginning of the pull, right around 2500 RPMs, and I take a look at all 6 cylinders and the ignition timing. So we go through, timing is good in the beginning, and then we hit our knock event right here. And as you can see, the timing gets a little choppy. You wanna see each cylinder stay within 3 degrees of one another, is again what I've been told from the guys at Pro Tuning Freak. So I go through our logs, and this is what we're working on in the mid-range, right around 4,400 RPMs. My high-pressure fuel pump is maxed out. So no check engine lights, no hesitations, car feels great. But as you can see, the numbers don't lie, and target for my high-pressure fuel pump is 2305. We're at 1320, so 1,000 PSI below target for my high-pressure fuel pump. So I can only imagine that that pump is working pretty damn hard. So that's what we're working on right now in my version 2 of my custom tune. And as you can see, the timing, look at it, it's just all over the place. So, and we're almost, you know, we're, as far as target boost goes, 19.2, and we're over boosting 21.4. So you want to stay plus or minus 1 pound of boost. That's good. This is 2 pounds of boost above target, so you could say that we're over boosting a little bit. So again, that's why I wanted to detune, and 21 pounds of boost on the stock N55 turbo is pretty much the max reliably. So you don't want to go over that. I'd rather see, you know, stay under 20 and just have the car happy. So go through the rest of the pull. Again, timing's all over the place. So I emailed this to Kerry and I gave him my concerns. I posted it on the forums, a couple guys on there, I value their opinion, and they took a look and said, yeah, this tune is way too aggressive. So next thing I did was a little bit of an experiment, but I downloaded the Stage 2 OTS E30 map to see how that compared to my custom tune, and it was pretty much night and day. So first thing we look for, there's no knock detected on this pull. Go to the beginning of the pull and just check out this timing. It's insane. It's just perfect. The whole pull.
Next thing we do, right in the mid-range, 4,400 RPMs. High-pressure fuel pump target is actually higher on the OTS map versus my custom tune. And we're barely under, like no cause for concern, 2,652. That's actually higher than the target high-pressure fuel pump on my custom tune. So high-pressure fuel pump's happy. Target boost, 17.4, and we're spot on right there. Now my custom tune was 19.2 PSI, so we are minus 2 PSI on this OTS map, and you can definitely feel it. The car does not feel as fast. It doesn't pull all the way to redline like it did on my custom tune, and the car didn't sound as aggressive on this map. It just sounds so much more alive on my custom tune, and so those were the differences that I noticed right out of the gate. But each log, and as you can see, timing just looks great throughout the whole log, just perfect. So that made me really happy that I have this map to rely on while I'm in between maps, or you know, if the custom tune I still feel like it's too aggressive on version 2, then I'll just revert back to this OTS map. And the third log we're gonna look at is a revised version. So we're in the middle of custom tuning once again. This is version 2, and this is, we're getting close to the end as far as completion of the custom tuning process. So this is a revised version. I would say this is the second to last. There's going to be one more version right after this, so keep that in mind because it's not totally dialed in yet. But first thing we look for, no knock detected. Go to the beginning of the pull, and timing looks a lot better on this custom tune versus my first tune. We'll go to that mid-range and check on the high-pressure fuel pump. Now, high-pressure fuel pump is better. Remember, it was in the 1300s on my custom tune V1. It's 200 PSI above that, still below. I mean, target's 2252, we're at 1506. If Kerry thinks this is okay and well within the limitations of the stock high-pressure fuel pump, then we will stay here. He's the pro in this. He's been doing this for years. Just because it's below target, I'm not gonna worry about it. If he says it's fine, it's fine. I'm not gonna stress about it. But we're still slightly overboosting. We're right here in the mid-range, 18.3. So target on V1 was 19.2. V2 is gonna be 18.3, so minus 1 pound of boost. Still overboosting a tad, but again, it's only for a slight second, and then we're pulling towards red line. Timing looks a lot better than it did on custom tune version 1. And so those were three different pulls, three different maps, and this is part one of part two series. Part two, I'm gonna go over the final custom tune version 2, and I'm gonna give my honest opinion on this entire process, because this has taken weeks. And you know, it's a bit of a headache and a lot of back and forth. Nothing against Kerry Jordan, it's just I want the car to be happy, and I want to give you guys my overall honest opinion on whether or not you should run with, now this is with the stock high-pressure fuel pump. I'm gonna give you my honest opinion whether you should do a custom tune, spend the 600 bucks and do it, or just run the Stage 2 off-the-shelf E30 map. So stay tuned for that video. I'm also gonna have my buddy's 1M for a full week. I'm gonna do a full detail for him and ceramic coat the car and do a full in-depth review. The BMW 1M is one of my dream cars, and if you're new to my channel, I had a 135i for about 5 years. So I had the N54, I had a full bolt-on, Stage 2 Plus, E30, all that good stuff. So it would be cool to compare a N54 to an N55. And be back in that platform. So that's coming up next. A lot of good content coming up. I appreciate you guys tuning into my channel. Please consider subscribing. Hit the thumbs up button. I'll catch you later.